All right, we're here with Ben Patch from the men's team. Really excited to sit down with Ben, one of the best in the world at what he does, and also has some really cool hobbies outside of volleyball. So, Ben, how's the summer going so far?
Well, got my tan on, which is always a plus. But no, the summer is like super good.
Yeah.
We just got back from vacation, 2 weeks off, which is really nice, and then a kind of a ramp-up week in Hawaii, and coming off a five-week competition period for VNL and winning a bronze medal. So we're feeling pretty good and stepping back into it, ready to get going again. So yeah. Summer's been chill.
Awesome.
Pretty good. Yeah.
Doing a busy summer, you guys got world champs later.
Yeah.
How important is it for you to take some time away from volleyball when you're just in the grind all the time?
You know, as a decorated athlete that you are, volleyball is such a mental game, and being able to kind of detox and release is so important, because as meticulous as volleyball is, it like occupies your mind so much, all the skills, and so being able to step away, kind of gain outside perspective, and then kind of regroup and bring that back in, I think really, I don't know, helps like almost refine your mind when you when you step back onto the court. So yeah, vacation was good.
Yeah, good.
For sure.
You've got a lot of fun stuff going on outside of volleyball. When did you start with photography, and how did it go from a hobby into like a business now?
So you just revealed my alias. I'm just kidding. You know, I've really tried to push myself as an artist and trying to create stuff that's like kind of different and unique. And photography and taking the photos is like maybe a fourth of it. The rest of it is like, how do you interact with people? How do you get people to open up? Because anyone can take like a pretty photo and put like some nice filter on it, but like to like feel something behind the photo is something that I think kind of, no, actually for sure it takes more time and more effort,
right,
and more understanding of like how to get people to like be vulnerable with you. Because I mean, that's what really makes a photo, is the energy behind it.
Yeah.
That's a long-winded answer, but
yeah, I like it.
I take photos.
It makes sense.
Yeah.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
How does that help you in volleyball?
In volleyball, like, you know, it's super organic, always changing, and you kind of have to think on a whim and be creative. And with volleyball, it's like, I've really noticed the more that I've tried to structure it and like it has to be this way every time, the more like it never goes how I want. And
amen.
Like, yeah, really though. And and it's not fun.
Yeah,
but like, man, something I've really loved this year is like I've kind of let myself go and just be creative like I do in photography. And it's like, whoa, like the nuances of the sport that I've been playing for 5-6 years is like, it's completely new now that I'm like letting it be something completely new and organic and creative, just like in photography, where that's exactly what you're doing. You're approaching a subject, a new person, a new couple every single time. You creatively have to like think about what would represent them the best, how would I get them to open up the best. And besides, you know, direct correlation, being able to step outside and do something completely different from volleyball and like kind of be, I don't know, open in a different way creatively really helps just to like release energy and do something completely different from athletics. So
what are you most looking forward to this summer with World Champs coming up?
We're like really creating like something cool. Like this group of guys is like so dope.
Yeah. Like, seems like it.
Really though.
Yeah.
Like everyone's just like opening up, and I'm really looking forward to like not only competing with these guys, but really getting to know everyone a little bit more. The more that I feel like we open up and kind of like congregate together, the more stronger we are as a team. Like we're really resilient and really vulnerable with one another, and I only could think that that would just have the most positive impact on us going forward. So I think moving into World Championships is just gonna be super sick, because we're all on the same page, we're all working really hard together, and then we're all like trying to connect like soul-wise as brothers and family and humans and all that cool stuff. So
So when you speak to kids, let's say a boys team that's 15, 16, what's your message, is that it?
Individuality is key. And this world is full of so many people trying to be something they're not. And something that we're learning is there's so much power in diversity. This team is full of individuals. And the more that we expose that and let ourselves go, the stronger that we'll become. And so young kids, like my advice to you would just to embrace who you are.
Yeah.
Whatever that is, like let yourself be free and find power in and the gifts that you've been given and the soul and energy that you share and that will be a strength to you as you go forward in whatever your pursuits are.
Love that.
Yeah.
Awesome.